the house. He's so good. Lord, you're so good.
It might as well be Christmas morning because it feels like Christmas.
It feels like Christmas already. We have Christmas in our hearts all year, for real. But today, as we celebrate together and everybody sings and as we hear the word of God, we're going to get into this season together and make sure that we're doing it for the right reasons. Amen? The Christ of Christmas is who we celebrate today. And he is the Christ of Christmas in our hearts and our lives, and he changes everything. And I believe that in this upcoming year, as we celebrate right through this season and into a brand new year, that 2024 is going to be the best year we've ever seen. The Lord's got us. We believe in the good things of God over your life, over your family's life, over the generations that come after you, that the Lord is doing his work. And we are people of the word of God here. We're going to get some of that word in by singing it, by preaching it today. So I want you to really be involved. Be involved. Clap when you want to clap. Shout when you want to shout. And let's give some great praise to a great God today. Somebody say amen. Lord, you're good. We give you praise today. We thank you for the men and women in the building, those watching online, Lord. We pray a great blessing upon this house, that your spirit will be so real to people in their lives, God, that we would look to you as our source, our only source in this world. The one who can give life, who gives us life. You came to us to give us life. You came to give us grace and hope and faith, Lord. And today we take that and we make something out of it, Lord, what you've created us to do. Lord, we give you great praise and great honor on this time of Advent as we celebrate you coming to our earth and changing everything. Thank you for changing everything. Thank you for changing us. Lord, we thank you that you are unchanging. You're a great God of all power and all creation. We give you praise and glory and honor. And everybody said, in Jesus' name, amen. 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 Amen and amen. Amen. The Lord is good.
Let's enjoy have the a program. Great time It'll be beautiful. This morning.
Oh, hey. King to see. Ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. Our finest gifts we bring. Ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. To lay before the King. Ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. 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 So to honor him, pa-rum-bum-bum-bum. When we come, baby Jesus, pa-rum-bum-bum-bum. I am poor boy to pa-rum-bum-bum-bum. I have no gifts to bring, pa-rum-bum-bum-bum. Oh, that's to give a king, pa-rum-bum-bum-bum.
Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, your king is coming to you. He is just and having salvation, lowly and riding on a donkey, a colt, the foal of a donkey. The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, a child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. New Life Space Coast presents to you Joy.
Come on, New Life, put your hands together.
While shepherds camp there watching over silent flocks by night, behold, throughout the heavens there shone a holy light. I said, go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. The shepherds feared and trembled when lo, above the earth rang out an angel chorus, then hailed our Savior's birth. Down in a lowly manger a humble Christ was born, and God sent us salvation on that blessed Christmas morn. So I said, go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Sought both night and day. I asked the Lord to help me, and He showed me the way. He made me a watchman upon the city walls. And if I am a Christian, I am the least of all. So I said, go. Over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Go tell it. Go tell it. Go on and tell it now. Go, go, go on and tell about Him. Stepped into creation with fire for all to see, brought every tribe and nation to their knees, arriving with the host of heaven in royal robe and crown, the rulers of the earth all bowing down. But you chose meekness over majesty, wrapped your power in humanity. Glory be to you alone, King who reigns from a manger throne. My life, my praise, everything I owe to Jesus, the King on a manger. Could have won. walked into your glory, into the heart of Rome. Showed them splendor like they never known. But you wrote a better story in humble Bethlehem, Creator in the arms of common man. You will die for our redemption, and you rise so we can live. Glory be to you alone, King who reigns from a major throne. My life, my praise, everything I own, to Jesus the King. To the cradle, from cradle to the cross, let heaven and nature sing, this is our King. But the grave couldn't hold him, our God is overcome. Let heaven and nature sing, this is our King. From heaven to the cradle, from cradle to the cross, let heaven and nature sing, this is our King. But the grave couldn't hold it, our God is overcome. Let heaven and nature sing, this is our King. All hail the King, all hail the King, all hail the King. My life. Jesus lay down his sweet head. The stars in the sky look down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay.
All right. Clap your hands, church. Massive stuff going on up here. Justin. Come on, church. Celebrate our Christ today. It's a great day. It's a day the Lord has made. We're blessed with you today, and Merry Christmas to you. God bless you abundantly. Man, what a presentation so far, right? Clap your hands one more time for this great presentation. One time. Very much unlike the very first Christmas program that we ever did, Sandra and I, when we were pastoring a little church over on the west side of Orlando. And my dad was the state overseer of the denomination, and he was there. And we did a couple things, and I asked him to stand and pray. And he started praying for the program to come, and I was really kind of perplexed because it was over. I'm thinking, Dad's not a good prayer. This thing is gone, man. We did our little acrostic, and you know, that was it. C is for Jesus, right? It was done, and we've laughed about it ever since, that he prayed for a program that was done. That's all right. This one is going on. Clap your hands one more time for this great celebration today, this great team up here. Amen? Amen. Well, let me just say it needs to be said, and we want to say that this is our first presentation since Susan McQuinn. And she was a massive worker. You always say it takes 4 or 5 people to do somebody's job. Well, it does. And we love her. We're mad at her. She went a little soon, don't you think? But, you know, I just want to say thank God for the people that the Lord sends and fills in every gap in this great house of God. Amen? Right? Where are you, Joni? Would you stand? Where is Joni? I want her to stand. You stay, our choir director, Joni Hawthorne, right there. Whoa! And our New Life Choir. Clap your hands for the New Life Choir. Now, we're not about to stop, are we? And our New Life Band. What about this New Life Band up here? We love you guys and gals. Man, massive stuff over here. God bless you abundantly. It's good. Our worship leaders, our worship team, our choir, our people that are here today, they're our people. This is New Lifers, and they're good. Let me just tell you, they're good. And we're blessed to have them. You know, I'm sorry, I'm a little sensitive today. It's okay. The house is sensitive. It's a good house, isn't it? As people came in, I said to someone, you know, this isn't my church anymore. I don't know anybody here. And I'm glad it isn't mine anymore, because it transitioned away to a great pastor's couple, Pastors Jason and Mindy Linkus. What a great leadership we have. And we love them. So I get to do the handiwork here. I'm here to do the stuff that needs to be done. And I just wanted to say a few things about tonight. We're on at 5:30. This morning about 4:30, I wasn't sure we were on at all. But thank you for coming anyway. Crazy night, wasn't it? It's a December hurricane, man, and here we are. And thank you for making it through the wind and the double hairspray day and getting to New Life today. You're blessed to be here, aren't you? Aren't you glad you did that? Yeah, you are. Man, it's good. It's so good. Sandra and I are so blessed with you and with this great house and the great beauty of this moment. I just want to say thank you again to Joni for her leadership. That's her husband over there, Conrad over there on that B3 stuff right over there. Yeah, man. And I just want to say to Marshall, that young man that's over here singing, Marshall kind of, you know, people just fall into their callings. And it's important. Marshall has risen in our church and in this house to a great leadership dimension. And he just leads us on, man. He's done so good here. Thank you, Marshall. Where are you, Marshall? Somewhere, there he is, front row. We've got the spotlight on you, man. And all of these guys and gals, I could say that to every one of them. But Justin, what about that voice right over there? Justin, would you stand up? And thank you, man. Yeah. And all of this band and all that goes on here with these vocals, every Sunday, we have a massive celebration of life. And this is a very special one at Christmas time. And I just want to say thank you to the tech team. You never even pay any attention to the tech team unless they make a mistake, and they're not going to make one. So just go ahead and clap your hands for all those people back there in the booth, right? All the work. Thank you. Thank you so very much. We appreciate it so very much, and we thank you and bless you abundantly. Jermaine is the leader of our tech team, and he has a great group around him, the camera people and all the people that give us sound. And amen? All right, go ahead. It's okay. I don't know how Paul the Apostle made it without a tech team. I don't know how he had it. But he seemed to get through okay, right? Absolutely. Let me see what all I have here. I wanted to tell you that we are going to receive an offering today, but we're not going to receive it like we usually do. It's going to be at the door. Make out your check before you leave or give your cash. Put an envelope. It didn't cost you anything to get in here. It's going to cost you a whole lot to get out. We have some major muscle men that are our ushers right here. So you can stay here all afternoon, or you can give your offering on the way out. So just remember to do that. I think it's a good thing to do. Be a little awkward this morning to pass the plate, but you always want to give, and this is your opportunity as you leave today. Tonight we're on at 5:30. We got cookies, and we got stuff going. If you don't have cookies to bring, don't stay home. Come and take some. You know, it's all right. It's a great night. Bring 2 dozen cookies if you can. We're going to have a movie in here, a black and white movie in the sanctuary at 5:30. It's a Christmas. What a great Christmas. What's that black and white? What? It's a Wonderful Christmas, right? Is that it? One of those. It's a Wonderful Life. Thank you, Pastor Mindy. It is a Wonderful Life. It's a Wonderful Life with you, I'll tell you that. You're a wonderful gift of God to us. And in the mall, there's going to be cookies and coffee and drinks. And in the children's worship area, there's going to be all children's carrying on. So it's a great night tonight at 5:30, so come and be a part of tonight. We brought it inside. We were going to have a bonfire out there. I'm glad we made the decision not to. We are not going to have a bonfire in here, so just don't be looking for that, all right? Only the fire of the Holy Ghost this morning. How about that? Is that all right? Absolutely. I'd like to say, too, that, talking about money, that this church is so liberal and such a giving church that we do have money. And if you do not have enough money to go around, we probably don't have enough money to pay everybody's house payment, but we have money. I have money in my pocket that's been given to me by this church. And if you have any need today, we don't want you to leave with a need. If we can help you at all, if your baby needs a present or you need a tree or you need dinner or you need anything that we can help you with, I have a pocket full of money. And I have it in envelopes. I've designed it here. It's all over. I got money all over my pockets. But it's not my money. It's given to me to give to you. And don't be embarrassed. Don't make yourself embarrassed. It doesn't have to be evident. It doesn't need to be awkward. Just see our pastors or our ushers or an elder and mention it. See me. And we'll be very, very private about transitioning some money to you. We don't want to keep it. It was given to us to give away. And clap your hands for you, church. You're so liberal. Thank you. Amen. Amen. I believe I did pretty good there. It's pretty good, right? I want to thank you guys before I introduce our next group that are praying for Sandra and I. You know, I lost my brother this last week. And Sandra and I will be going up at the end of the month into Chicago area to do his funeral. And, you know, it's kind of odd because it was Mom and Dad, Malcolm and Hannah, and Larry and Gary, and now Larry's the only one left. And I'm going to be here a while, okay? But you pray for us. I'm going to minister to the family and give great honor to my brother. And I appreciate it. You know, I realized something yesterday, though, that I kept saying I've lost my brother. I've lost my brother. No one's lost if you know where they are. I said nobody's lost if you know where they are. Hallelujah. I know where he is. And that gives me great joy today. And I'm blessed. I'm so honored today to have a group of pastors invited the Caroling Company to be with us today. And it's Jeremy and Shalisa and Julian and Jenny and Al. We called Shalisa and asked, could the Caroling Company come, a group? They have hundreds of people during this time of the year. She can tell you if she'd like. Hundreds of people that go out 4 and 6 or 8 at a time across all of Central Florida, East Central Florida. And we weren't expecting for the owner of Caroling Company to come, but Shalisa is. Shalisa is our goddaughter. She's Rick's daughter. Rick's right over here. And my very first best friend, Rick Sloan. And he's here today. We're blessed with them, these families that are part of our lives. I know that they wanted to come to the Christmas celebration, but Sandra's doing dinner and we're watching the Bucks game, so that's probably why Rick is here, probably why they're here. But they're enjoying a great Christmas celebration. Rick and Denise, we love you, Hannah. Thank you all for being here today. And this team right here, you're going to love this. I'll tell you, thank you, Shalisa, and thank you for this great, I know, how many people are in the group that you guys have?
We have about 100 traditional carolers, and yeah. We have dozens more to our pop groups, the Mistletones, which we'll also give you a taste of right now.
Oh, yeah, are you?
Yeah.
Are we got that on?
Yeah, let's see.
I know.
Yeah. Okay, here we go. Yeah, we have close to 100, and then we have our contemporary groups like the Mistletones and the Santa Sisters. We'll do a couple Mistletone songs for you today, too, like to kick it off.
This is your husband?
That's my husband, Jeremy.
And this is your son?
My son, Julian's going to do a couple songs with us, and our friends, Al and Jenny,
clap your hands for today. We call them the Caroling Company, but they're very special friends. And we're so blessed that they're with us today. And you'll enjoy them. Clap your hands for them after they sing and all they do. And welcome and blessings and Merry Christmas from Sandra and I. God bless you. Caroling Company.
Good morning.
He's hard to get the mic away from, huh?
1, 2, 3, 4.
City sidewalks, busy sidewalks, dressed in holiday style.
In the air there's a feeling of Christmas.
Children laughing, people passing, greeting smile after smile.
And on every street corner you'll hear silver bells. Silver bells.
again. Ooh, strings of street lights, even stoplights, blink a bright red and green as the shoppers rush home with their treasures.
So much, everybody. It's truly just a blessing and an honor to be here. We love you guys. As Larry said, we're all family, man. Jason and Mindy and Shalisa grew up together, and I get to be here on stage with my son and my good friends, and just kind of spread the joy of the season. So yeah, exactly. Shalisa and I have owned the Caroling Company for
23 years.
And we absolutely love it. We see it as a part of our ministry as well, singing in a four and sometimes five-part harmony. So right now we're going to do a traditional song that's a really, really kind of fun. Everybody watches it every year. It is, of course, White Christmas.
The sun is shining, the grass is green, the orange and palm trees sway. There's never been such a day at New Life Space Coast FLA.
But it's almost December the 24th, and I'm longing to be up north.
Every card I write. Bring it home.
May your days be merry and bright, so bright. And may all your Christmases be white.
Thank you so much.
See you guys.
We're gonna do a four-part traditional caroling arrangements. We're gonna say goodbye to Julian for a little bit. It's not just because he looks better in this shirt than I do. This is one that is really beautiful. It really kind of paints the picture of the night Jesus was born in the manger with all of the falling snow and a very still, still moment. I love it when the Lord says to us, be anxious for nothing, especially in this busy holiday season, right? Peace, be still, throw it on him. So this one is called Still, Still, Still. To do another traditional Christmas carol for you. This is, of course, the other name of Jesus, God with us. O come, Emmanuel.
O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel, which mourns in lonely exile here. Until the Son of God appears. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
O come, thou day spring, thine spirit by thine advent here. Disperse the gloomy clouds of night, and death's dark shadows put to flight.
Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou King of David, come and open wide our heavenly home. Make safe the way that leads on high. Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O
Okay, we don't have a lot of time left, so we are going to squeeze every Christmas carol ever into the next 2 minutes. See if you guys can catch up. I know, choir, you're going to sing along with us.
You got everybody's got to sing along when you know it.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye, oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Oh, come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Christ the Lord, the first Noel, the angel did say, was to certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay, in fields where they lay keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so deep. Noel, 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 born is the King of Israel.
It came upon a midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their hearts of gold.
Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from heaven's all gracious King.
The world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing.
While shepherds watch their flocks by night, all seated on the
we stumped them.
The angel of the Lord came down, and glory showed around, and glory showed around. Around.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, the newborn King. Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Joy to the world, the Lord.
is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing.
Woo! Wow!
Thank
you. That was awesome. What do you think, Jason and Mindy? You want to hear one more?
Yeah.
All right. Very cool. That was a marathon.
Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you so much. We do have one last one to do for you. This is a Christmas wish from all of us to all of you. Everybody with the Caroling Company. Thank you.
Wow. Wow, that was awesome. Thank you so much. That was so, so special.
So wonderful.
Oh my goodness. So awesome. Thank you guys so much for coming over. It was absolutely amazing. Ah, the Caroling Company. Yeah. Come on now. God bless you. Pastor Mindy Linkus.
What a wonderful time of year. We think about the people we love. We think about gifts that, you know, we could give, gifts that are meaningful, like my mom gives good, meaningful gifts from the heart. It makes you think, oh, wow, she sees what I'm interested in. She cares about me. Well, as we're unwrapping presents from others that touch our hearts, and as we're preparing to wrap gifts, to give to those that we love, friends of ours, people that we're in relationships with, I want to remind you of a gift that I get every day from the one who created me, from Jesus, from the creator of everything. I'm an artist, and I think of ways to find new inspirations all over. And the biggest inspiration that I find, no matter where I go and how many beautiful and inspiring things that I've seen, whether ancient or some emerging inspiration that I see, the greatest inspiration is the touch of the Lord's hand on my life. It always comes right when I need it. Just a whisper. It's not just a mother's intuition to help you out in time of need, but the whispering of the living God, the Holy Spirit within us, empowering our lives to be able to create each step with love and grace. It's the wisdom. She's so beautiful. She might cost you all you have, but we need wisdom. And wisdom is found in the living Word of God. Make sure you have a Bible. Oh, it's a treasure. I just traveled to Malta, the place where Paul had his shipwreck. And in 3 months, he transformed the whole culture of the island. And when I went there, it's still transformed by the gospel of the good news of Jesus Christ to this very day. He made an impact because he brought that gift, the wisdom of God, the good news. I opened my fresh new Bible straight from Malta with a super cute pink leather cover. I Ubered to get this in Malta, okay? It's a cool Bible. And I just opened it up because it's new. And I was like, lead me, Lord. And I went to Proverbs 4, verse 4. And it comes and it says, and he taught me. And he spoke to me. Listen to my words. Keep them in your heart. Just rip a hole. Just make yourself just bleed with ripping your heart open to receive the wisdom of God. It will infiltrate your whole self. It will inspire you to a point where you become a wellspring of life, love, grace, liberty, forgiveness, peace, harmony, prosperity, trueness, truth, overcoming, victory, limitless, and it will overflow to everyone you know. Please give the gift of the wisdom that God's given you. Maybe something he taught you this year. And make sure you share it with others. This year, what he taught me is that motherly intuition, that voice inside that I hear that just tells me to stop, to wait, to be quiet. I don't like that one. And you know, I used to every once in a while listen and be like, yeah, and then my word would be, yeah, you know what, I knew that. I knew better. But this year, I'm listening every time. Yes. Time is short. I've got to listen every time. And even this morning, he was guiding me through my morning. I'm just getting ready. Just getting ready for my day. And the Holy Spirit, the creator of my life, the one who I allow to lead my steps, said, shh, wait. And Jason was walking away and he said, ooh, wait, be still, close the window. And I put my hand on Jason's shoulder and I just said, and he was so busy, ready to go, and I just captured his attention and we just stood there. We stood in the place that God had provided, had ordained for us to stand in that moment. And I felt a little whisper that said, close the window. So I stepped back, I looked, and a huge mirror blew down and shattered into so many pieces. And it would have fell on me, except for I was stepping only into the place guided by our living Savior, Jesus, who came that day. And never, never will he leave you. Always, always, always listen to him when he speaks to you. And obey, and the last word in that scripture says, obey and live. Let's live. Live to the full. I love you. Merry Christmas from my heart. I love you.
Still we see the light above thy deep and dreamlessly the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light, the hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in. Be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels proclaim glad tidings till, oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel. Soon deliver you, Mary.
your baby boy would give sight to the blind man. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know? Mary, yes, Mary, did you know? See, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? And the sleeping child you're holding is the great I Am.
I pray, bless all the deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name.
Come on, stand to your feet today, church. Let's worship a little bit.
Worthy is your
Come on up.
Name,
We're gonna praise in this house today. We're gonna worship in this house.
You deserve the praise.
Become stronger with God today.
Worthy is your
oh, worthy
name.
Is his name.
Worthy is your name, Jesus.
You
deserve the praise.
Oh, worthy is
worthy
your name, God.
Is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus.
You
deserve the praise.
Oh, worthy.
Worthy is your
oh,
name.
For me.
The praise.
Let out
worthy
your prayers today.
Your name.
You and God.
Worthy is your name.
Don't leave without getting something today.
Jesus.
This is your chance, church.
You deserve the praise.
Oh, worthy is your name.
Worthy is your name.
Jesus.
Keep going.
You deserve praise.
Oh, worthy is your
name. Oh, my life.
Worthy is your
name. Oh, my life, you've been worthy.
Jesus.
You deserve
worthy.
It.
You deserve the praise. Worthy is
sing out, holy is your name.
Holy is your name. Jesus. You deserve the praise. Holy is your name.
Worthy.
Worthy is your name. Jesus.
You're worthy.
You deserve the praise.
All the praise.
Worthy is your
name. Come on, church, let's build it back up again.
Worthy is
let's get a strong shout for God today.
Jesus.
You're worthy.
You deserve the praise.
Holy.
Holy is your name, Jesus.
No other God.
You deserve the praise.
Now forever,
oh worthy is your name.
Shout it today.
Worthy, worthy.
Holy is your name. Holy is your name,
Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name.
Sing worthy.
Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve praise. Worthy is your name.
One more time, sing it. Holy is your name.
Holy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Holy is your name.
One more time, just verses. Holy.
Holy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Holy is your name.
Beautiful church. Beautiful church. Beautiful. Oh, you're so, sounds so good today. Worthy is your name, Jesus. No other name but the name that is Jesus for me. I am delivered by the name of Jesus. I am delivered in the blood of Jesus. If you're saved today in the name of Jesus, say amen. Shout out today for Jesus. Come on, church. Let's go. Sing that one more time. Let's sing, worthy is your name.
Worthy is your name.
Jesus.
Oh, oh yeah.
We deserve the praise.
Oh, no worthy name.
Worthy.
No worthy name.
You're worthy.
Worthy is your name.
All my praise, all my life.
Worthy is your name.
Oh.
Worthy is your name.
Oh, Jesus. Jesus.
So worthy.
We deserve the praise.
Oh, worthy is your name. Worthy.
Worthy is your name.
Much better than this.
Worthy is
your feels like church.
Name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name.
Worthy is your name. One more.
Worthy is your name, Jesus.
Your name.
You deserve the praise. Oh, worthy is your name.
All of our worship goes to
you. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Oh, worthy.
Come on, God, nothing better, nothing better.
Can I tell you, church, can I pray? He's so good. He's so good. He's so good. Well, that's worship and new life right there, a day of worship. You know, beautiful people, God bless you. I have some words to tell you. You sit down for a moment. How many of you love the Word of God? Amen. Of the Word of God. The Word of God is the seed of God. It comes to get in our hearts and our minds and change things, to rearrange things, to make us better. And the Word became flesh, as the Word says in John chapter 1. The Word became flesh and made His dwelling among us. Why did He come? I have a few things I want to talk to you today, just briefly, about why He came. There's many reasons He came. You can look through the Scriptures and search out many things that He came to do, but I'm going to highlight a few today. Is that all right with you? In the beginning, I'm going to read in John 1:1. If you want to follow up here, you can. It says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. We're talking about Jesus here, my friends. We're talking about the Word. We're talking about Jesus. Somebody with me today. And Jesus was with God in the beginning. And Jesus was God. Come on, somebody. In the beginning, the Word. You know, in the beginning, the very beginning, it was Jesus, the Word. Because, you know, this is a big deal right here. How many of you know the Lord has always been with you? He's always been creative in our lives. The Word says, in Him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. Lord, thank you for lighting this thing up. Amen. He lit it up for you. The light shines in the darkness. The darkness has not overcome it and will not overcome it. Somebody say, the darkness will not overcome the light. We live a life of overcoming darkness and situations and circumstances. I know it's tough out there sometimes, but let me tell you, no matter how dark it gets, the darkness will not overcome the light of the Lord Jesus Christ. No matter how trouble we're having in our world or our nation, in the wars, you know, the wars and rumors of wars, the Word says it must happen because there's something else coming up. Somebody say amen. The Lord's got plans for a great future for His people. I believe in those plans. How about you? Drop down to chapter 1, verse 9. It says, the true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world. Though He was in the world, it was made through Him. The world did not recognize Him. He came to that which was His own, but His own did not receive Him. Yet to all who did receive Him. How many in here have received Him today? All who have received Him. If you'll receive Him, look what you get. Look at it. To those who believed in His name,
He gave the right to become children of God. Children not born of natural descent or human decision. It's not something I just made up and wanted to get done. The Lord said, I'm going to make you mine. But born of God, the Word became flesh. Thank you, Lord, for coming in the flesh, taking our pain to the cross, taking our sin to the cross. Somebody say amen. Thank you for your resurrection. Thank you for your ascension, the beautiful high priest that you are today over our confession. Became flesh, made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. What did he come to do? Well, one of those things I want to highlight today is he came to bring grace and truth. You can't get past this grace life that God wants us to live in. There's nothing bigger or better than the love and grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. This grace means everything. This unmerited favor, you can't earn it, you don't deserve it. You didn't do good enough, you're not doing good enough right now. You won't do good enough in the future to deserve it, but the Lord said, I'm going to give it to you anyway. And if he's going to give it to us, I want to take it. How about you? I want to take it. I want to live my life better. I want to do like Paul did and say, Lord, I want to live up to what I've already attained in you. He paid for it. He took care of it. But we today are living more and more up to it. How about 2024 being the year that we're going to go after? Amen. We're celebrating here. We're looking there. We're seeing God do things in our future. We've seen him do it in our past. We're seeing him do it right now. But I believe in the future that God has for this house. I believe in the future that God has for your house. Amen. He brought grace and truth. He came to do some things. He came to bring you grace and truth. He came to, in John chapter 1, verse 29, it says this, he came to take away the sin of the world. In 1 John chapter 3, verse 8, it says, the reason Jesus appeared to us was to destroy the works of the devil. To destroy the, you know, if he came to do it, how many of you know he did what he came to do? He destroyed the works of the devil. Don't be dealing in the works of the devil. There's really nothing there. The word says that he came and he destroyed death. In Timothy, in 1 Timothy, in 2 Timothy, it says, he did it. He came to destroy death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel of grace. If he did that for me, how am I living with that? How am I doing that? How are we doing? We have to take personal inventory. How am I doing with that? Am I guarding my heart? Am I not listening to the enemy's lies that he's trying to put in here, the arrows of the enemy? Am I truly guarding my heart, as it says in Proverbs? Above all else, guard your heart. It's the wellspring of your life. And I want my spring to be good. How about you? I want to be springing some good stuff out on this front row. Right here. Spring it. Over here on Carolyn Company, I'm going to spring it. You got to spring, or choir, spring it. I'm going to spring some good stuff. My spring's going to be good. How about you? I don't want to be giving some poisonous stuff to the world, to my family, to my household, to the people I come across on the street. I don't want to be spreading poison. I want to spread not the light and the love and the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. I got to guard my heart. You have to guard your heart. Above all else, when the word talks like that, I listen. Above all else, guard your heart. It's the wellspring of your life. Out of which, another version says, you've formed the borders of your life. You don't like the place that you're living. You think you're too confined. You want to spread your wings. Let me tell you what. The word of God says, guard your heart. It's important because you form the borders of your life. You want to make some bigger borders? Guard your heart. Don't listen to the enemy's lies. He's a liar. That's all he's got. He's a liar. Because the Lord came to and did to do this and did destroy the works of the devil. Anything else is just a lie. Luke chapter 19, verse 10 says, Jesus has come to seek and save that which was lost. To seek and save. He came to seek out the lost things. To save. Come on, somebody. His humanity. He came to seek and to save. He calls us to go out there and seek and save in his name, right? John chapter 10, verse 10 says, I came that they might have life and have it to the full. Have it to the full. How many of you ready for that full life? a no lack. He said, I've given you everything that you need for life and godliness. I've given it to you. I've given it to you. I brought it to you. I came to do this. If he came to do these things, my question to us is this. If Jesus came to do it, let him do it for you. If he came to do it, let him do it for you. And your faith rise and your heart rise and your recognition of his love and grace rise in this season. We say, thank you, Jesus, for coming to change the world. Thank you, Lord, for being, as you call yourself, through the word of God, the Savior of the world. Let him save your world today. Somebody say amen. Let him save your world. Let him save your people. Let him save you. Somebody hearing the word of God today. How many of you enjoy what's going on here today? Amen. It's a good day. Amen. It's a good day. He came to save. He seek and save. Seek and save. You know, I want to say this. I'm going to go get my phone. Hold on one second. I wrote this down the other day. I didn't know if I was actually going to say it, but today or any day. But I wrote it down because, and I'll go ahead and end with it. Hope you like it. It's not rehearsed. And then the other thing, can I find it in my phone? I don't know. There it is. All right. So I will end with this. I was just sitting there. I was thinking about the goodness of God. And I was just praying. I was in meditation in that time. I just thought in my heart, and this is a lot for maybe if you're out there watching or in here, and maybe you're having trouble with your belief system, and you're not putting your faith in the right things. You got to put your faith in the right things. His name is Jesus Christ, amen. So I believe in Jesus, as you do, obviously. Many of you, maybe you're in here, maybe you don't. You may have questions. If you're out watching today or listening on the radio today, you have questions. So I wrote this down. I said, I believe in Jesus. But even if I didn't believe it, I believe I would choose it as a way of life. Because watch what it offers. Choose to accept peace, to have a God to talk to and to talk to you. To live with faith, to hold on to hope, to live with love, to get grace and to give grace, to forgive and to be forgiven, I think I would choose it. Even if I didn't believe. How many of you know that all becomes powerful when you do believe? Because who wouldn't want those things? Who wouldn't want to have a life of peace and have a God to talk to? Who wouldn't want to live with faith and a hope in your heart? Who wouldn't want to get grace and to give grace, to forgive and to be forgiven? See, it's so good, it's just too good not to believe. So you believe it because it's just that good. Thank you, Jesus. Everybody bow your heads in the building with me today. Everybody bow your heads. Bring the lights up just a little bit so I can see people. Just a little bit. If you're in the building today, if you're in the building today, or you're watching me today, or you're listening today, today is the day life gets better. You take hold by faith. If you don't know this Christ, let me tell you right now, you've been running, turn around, he's right there. This is your moment today. Don't leave here today without giving your heart to this amazing Savior, a God who will grace you, love you. He's after you today to love you. Nothing else but to love you and to show you his grace. If you're in the building today and you don't know this Jesus, or you're running back to this Jesus today, I want you to do this right here. Everybody's head is bowed and eyes are closed. Well, all I want you to do right here is just simply raise up your hand. And when you raise up your hand, you're saying in your heart, yes, Pastor, that's I need this Savior. I've been running too long. I've been avoiding this subject, but today the subject is right here in front of you. And it's up to you to choose. And you today choose to believe. It's your choice. Choose to believe. Raise up your hand right now. Brother, I see you believing. I see you. Raise up your hand right now all over the building. I see you believing. I see you giving your heart. I see you believing. Just raise up your hand if that's you today. It's an act of your faith. The faith is action. I see you. I see you. The Lord is doing his work in the house. I see you. And lives are changing in the house of God today. Somebody say amen. Jesus, thank you. You put your hands down. If you raised your hand or if you didn't raise your hand, I want everybody in the building to say this prayer with me. Say, dear Lord Jesus, thank you for coming to us. Thank you for coming to me.
I believe in you. I choose you. I give my heart to you. I give my life to you. And I thank you today for my salvation. In Jesus' name. Somebody said amen. Give him praise today. That happened all over the building. Oh, man, what a beautiful day. What a beautiful day. Man, the Lord is good, amen? Yeah, that's beautiful. If you need prayer after service, you want to come and hang out with some people, some prayer partners will be down here. Come this way. Make sure you're on your way out. As Dr. Lincoln said, if you wanted to give a gift to in your offering today, you can make that happen back there. But before we get out of here today, we're going to party just a little bit more. Is that all right? Ain't no party like the Holy Ghost. Party against the Holy Ghost. Party against time. Check this out. Look at these lovelies, huh? These are a part of our wonderful New Life Academy right here at New Life Space Coast. This is our future, what we're raising up here. Many, many others, they couldn't be here today, but they're here today. I want you to clap your hands for New Life Academy kids. They're going to be singing with us. I love them. Everybody, stand up on your feet. We're going to rejoice. We're going to sing joy. I want you to sing it like you mean it today. I love you. Merry Christmas. Thank you for spending this morning with us.
To the world, oh, we will sing. the world.
So good to have you today. What a beautiful day, amen? Go in the grace and the love and the protection of God. I bless you today as you go into the world to do the good things that God has called you to do. You know, he said, I am the light of the world. He said it about himself. But he was getting ready to get out of here. He started pointing to people. He said, look, 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 you are the light of the world. You are the light of the world. Go out there and light it up. Love you guys. Merry Christmas.